Welcome to the television ministry of Souls Harbor Tabernacle. We are located in the shadow of beautiful Crowder's Mountain, 271 Camp Rotary Road, Gastonia, North Carolina. Now be blessed by the anointed ministry of Pastor James Chambers and Church.
Well, praise the Lord. So good to be with you tonight. This is Pastor Chambers from Souls Harbor Tabernacle, Gastonia. We're so glad to be coming in your home tonight. By the way of television, we thank you for tuning in. We would like to invite you to be with us at church in the morning. Our service starts at 11 o'clock. We're temporarily not doing Sunday school because of the COVID-19, but we will get back to doing that. But our worship service is at 11 o'clock in the morning. Sunday night services at 6 o'clock. Midweek services Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. Have a great church in Dallas. Brother Eric Quinn, his wife Arlene, labor for the Lord there. They'd be so glad to have you. Their service times tomorrow are the same, 11 o'clock and 6 o'clock tomorrow night. And then Tuesday night at 7 o'clock is their midweek service. And then up in Mooresboro, I have another great church. Brother Chuck Poole's the pastor there. And he'd be glad to see you. He and his wife Joyce labor for the Lord there. They'd be so glad to see you tomorrow at 11 o'clock, 6 o'clock, or Thursday night at 7 o'clock. And we're just looking for God to move in a mighty way in all of our services. And we thank you for being with us. This is coming to you by way of recording. We recorded this earlier at the church. You know, felt like this is what we need to be doing at this time. And so we did. That number on the screen, Brother Donnie's by the phone. He'll take your calls and we pray over them. We can't pray over them on the air, but we do pray over them at the end of the service. Donnie prays on them as they come in, and he sends them to me, and I pray over them again, and then put them in the prayer box at home where they stay on the altar for the Lord until pray until God turns this thing around. God bless you. Thank you for being with us today. We're going to have the first song. We're going to let my sister Toddy come and sing for you tonight. At this time, just be in prayer for her. She sings. God bless you. Be sure to call that number on the screen. Song. I enjoyed that song. I just listened to the words of it sitting over there. This is the place where we pray. It's the place where we start, where we say till death do us part. This is the place where we say goodbye. This is the place where we dedicate our children. I'm glad somebody knew what the church is for. Amen. That's what we do here at the sanctuary. We thank God for it. We don't like all of those seasons as good as we do others. We don't like to say goodbye. But I don't know no better place to do it than right here where you start. Amen. Say goodbye. Amen. And one day we go on where there'll be no sad goodbyes, far away. So rejoice is the same, far away is a place where there'll be no more sorrow. Amen. I love that song, and I still do. I sing it every once in a while, just a line or two. I don't remember it. But I tell the devil every once in a while that far away is a place where there'll be no more sorrow. And I thank God for that. We're enjoying being with you tonight. I hope you're enjoying the program. Appreciate to having you watching us on TV, and we're just so glad to be with you. We do thank you. We did pre-record this program, but we have somebody live by the phone to take your calls. If you'd like to call in, Brother Donnie is waiting on your call. I'd like for you to write us. We're on a new venture here. We're recording these from the church. We feel good about it. It's a little easier on us. Plus, you'll see more people in our three churches and from this church, because it's easier on them than driving to Hickory every Saturday night at getting home at 11:30. It's just easier on us, and I think God's still using it, because we're still getting about the same 10 or 20 phone calls or more called in, and we're praying with you, and we're believing you, and we need you to be steadfast in your support. Help us all you can. We need it. We've had dropped off, but God's still supplying the need. And so far, everything's paid. We thank God for it. And we do feel like we're in the will of God to do what we're doing for now. I'm not saying we won't do some live later, but right now, we just feel like we found the will of God for now. That's what you got to do, one day at a time, one week at a time, one year at a time, and the Lord will help us. Also a pleasure tonight to have Sister Debbie with us. She's going to come and sing for you tonight. At this time, keep calling that number, talking to Donnie. Write the address down. Don't forget to write us. Pray for us. Send a love gift if you can. Pray for Debbie. She ain't been long. Had triple bypass surgery. She's doing good. God's blessed her. Pray for her as she sings. Thank you. good job. What a good song there. Amen. I am blessed. Amen. Thank God for it. Thank you for listening tonight. Appreciate you being with us tonight. I want you to pray for us as we go to the Word of God in Psalms 91. A real familiar scripture, but go to another place there and read a little bit. Another scripture, but this will be the text. And a very familiar scripture. Go ahead and continue to call that number on the screen. And we'll just believe God to meet your need tonight. Donnie will pray with you when he gets the call, and then he'll text those right to me at the end of the program. I'll pray over them again, put them in the prayer box, and keep them before the Lord on the altar. Amen. Thank you for listening tonight. Psalms 91, verse 1 just says, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty." And I just want to talk tonight. I don't know that I've ever used this scripture with this thought, but I feel like the Lord gave me this, and I just want to share it with you. The thought just simply over and over, God is faithful. Amen. Over and over, God is faithful. God's blessed me once. He's blessed me twice. He's been blessing me all my life. Amen. Over and over, God is faithful. "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High," that's you and me, "shall abide in the shadow of the Almighty forever." Amen. Not just today, but tomorrow, next week, yesterday. Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. And I thank God for it. God specializes in being faithful to faithful servants. Amen. I feel like God spoke that to me this morning early, or maybe last night when I was working on this message. But it's just simply that God specializes in being faithful to faithful servants. He even called some of them faithful, like faithful Abraham. And he related to some of them being faithful, that they're faithful servants. And I believe he just, you know, according to Chronicles, where he said, "The eyes of the Lord are going to and fro over the whole earth, looking for an opportunity to show himself strong in the behalf of those whose heart is right toward him." We know the qualification to have your heart right with God. But also, God's looking for, I believe, somebody that's got their heart right or faithful. They go on when they feel like it, go on when they don't feel like it, instant in season, out of season. I'm reminded of Elijah, and I'll just take you through this real quick. Won't read it all, but maybe just highlight some verses for you. But Elijah in 1 Kings chapter 17 and verse 1, he was faithful to God in even announcing 3.5 years of drought. Amen. I mean, any preacher would get up and tell somebody that we're fixing to get $1 million, you're fixing to get a new stimulus check or whatever. I mean, you'd be glad to give somebody some good news, you know, that God's going to bless you. But this man of God stood up and ended up, you know, being hated for telling the gospel's sake. But he stood up and said, "I promise you by the presence of the Lord that there'll be no rain. There'll be no rain for the length of 3.5 years. And the Bible said that that's exactly what happened. But then God takes the direction away from what he's doing to everybody and what he's allowing to happen to everybody. And he looks to Elijah, this faithful servant of God, who's dwelling in the secret place of the Most High and abiding in the shadow of the Almighty, what I'm preaching about tonight. And God has a chance, and he proves himself here. Opportunity is a better word, not chance. Life's not chance. God's not about chance. But opportunity God has here, and he takes advantage of it, and he tells this faithful man of God in verse 2 through 6, God tells him that he wants him to go down the Cherith to a brook, and he'll have plenty to drink there in this time of drought. He can go down there to that brook and drink, and "I've already commanded the ravens to come and feed you every morning. So you ain't got to worry about that. They're going to be there to feed you. And you got plenty of water to drink. So you just go on down there." And, you know, we wonder sometimes why God don't speak to more of us today. But one thing I noticed about those men of God, when God spoke to them, they acted on it. So he went to Cherith. Amen. He went down there to the brook. Amen. And God took care of him, done what he promised him to do. Verse 7 is an interesting verse of that chapter 17 of I believe it is, if I got the right place, of chapter 17 of 1 Kings, verse 1. Then at verse 7 now, very interesting, it says, "It came to pass after a while." It didn't happen in a moment. Didn't happen overnight, didn't happen in a day, but it came to pass. The course of time ran out, and the brook dried up. That's what the Bible said. Where God had led him to. Well, why did God lead him to a brook? It was a place. I mean, we pray, and the Lord taught us to pray, you know, give me my daily food, my daily needs. God didn't promise to tell you, outline it, what he's going to do for the next 10 years for you. Where you work now may be how God's using to get you groceries on the table now, but there may be another job, and in God's, it may be a mystery unfolding. God may have something else for you down the road. But until the brook dries up, you just enjoy the brook. Amen? So he did. And it's interesting to me that this man surely knew. I mean, they had sticks or measuring sticks or their eyes. He could see this brook drying up. But he didn't jump ship. He stayed there. It came to pass that it dried up. When it dried up, God had provision for him. But not until it dried up. Sometimes we jump ship. Chuck the other week preached about where, you know, on the shipwreck that Paul was on in Acts 27, how he told them they had to stay on the ship. Sometimes I know people's done that. I think people's been slow in moving when what God wants them to move. But more often than not, we think God ain't moving fast enough, and we're going to move and help God. But go back to my title over and over, God is faithful. Amen. If God give you water to drink today, he ain't going to let you thirst to death tomorrow. Amen. If God had a raven to feed you today, he'll have somebody to feed you tomorrow. Amen.
Right.
Don't worry about it. Cast your cares on him because he cares for you. But that brook dried up. That's where the over and over comes in with God. You stay where God has you. When the brook dries up, then you leave. You get in trouble moving too quick. If you could ask Naomi and Amalek tonight, they'd tell you they heard there's a famine. They took off. She lost a husband and two sons. I think by moving just on hearsay, hearing that there's a famine, hearing that we're going to starve to death over here, so we're going to Moab, where they knew they wasn't supposed to go, but they went and suffered great loss 10 years later, went back and said, don't call me Naomi no more, because I'm not blessed of the Lord anymore. Call me the name that Mara, whatever the name was, it's not right on my mind, but the name that she said called me, because God has dealt bitterly with me. But the fact is, Galatians is still true, that God is not, be not deceived, God is not mocked, for whatsoever man soweth, that shall he reap. So they went away from God, and they went back to God, and she was blessed, and her daughter-in-law that she took back with her was blessed also, amen. But he didn't jump ship. Over and over, God kept blessing him. So in verse 8, verse 9, God's speaking to him again, and he said, I got a widow woman down at Zarephath, and I want her to sustain you. And you know, God don't get his notes mixed up like I do. God don't give you the wrong scripture like I do. I'm human, but God's still God, and he knows what he's doing. But he didn't get things mixed up, he didn't get his wires crossed. He sent her down here to this woman with no question asked. He went down to this woman. He went down to Zarephath where she was at. And when she got there, he finds a woman about to starve to death. A woman out there that the Bible says, God is not looking like she could sustain herself, even him. You know, he gets down there. He finds this woman. It looks hopeless. A widow woman there with a handful of meal. That's right out of the Bible. And a little oil in the cruse and two sticks. First it says sticks. She says two sticks. Two sticks. And she just got enough. She said, give me a drink of water. She said, I'll do it. And she goes to get him a drink of water. And he said, and make me a little cake of bread, if you will. Why are you doing that? Because I'm hungry. And she said, I don't have a cake. I just got these two sticks, this little handful of meal, a little oil in my cruse, and I'm going to give this to me and my son, and we're going to eat this and die. And the average person would have said, how in the world is this woman going to sustain me? How in the world is this woman going to take care of me? But you got to go back to the text. Over and over again, God is faithful. I had him to move for me today. I can't give you the details, but I stepped out on faith and did something that cost me a little bit of money, and I turned around, and God gave me the money right back. Amen.
Amen.
I mean, it was just instant, you know, and it was amazing. I could tell you how it worked out. You'd never believe how it worked out, but God did it. I was trying to help somebody. God had somebody that was able to help me later, and God just done it all, you know. Over and over again, God's faithful. You have to just step out and believe God, amen, that God will do that. But here she was, looked hopeless. Verse 13, he said, make me a cake first. I've said it a lot of times, and it says she made him one. Don't say how big it was, but it said she made him one. I think it could have been the size of a quarter. I could have been, it'd been like a coin. It'd been a cake. It'd been a little one. It'd been bite-sized. You buy stuff at the store that size now, bite-sized crackers and things that you can get like that. She could have brought him one like that. I don't know how big it was, but he said, just make me a little cake first. Just a little one first. Verse 14, he prophesied to her that that meal barrel won't waste and the cruse of oil won't fail because God is faithful. Amen.
Amen.
Over and over, God is faithful. You ought to get that in your spirit today like I've got it in mine. And then I went to work for a little while and God proved it to me. Amen. Just proved, didn't have nothing to prove. I believed it before that happened. Amen. But God will just prove himself over and over and over again. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Verse 16 said, the barrel of meal wasted not, neither did the cruse of oil fail, because God is faithful. Challenge to Elijah or the widow woman, both of them had this challenge, but both of them accepted the challenge. She made the little cake first. Amen. He went down there. The woman didn't look like she could give nobody nothing. Amen. Didn't have nothing to give. And God did that for her. Over and over again, God is faithful. Do you believe that tonight? I can't hear you, but you could just say amen. Right where you at? If God is faithful to you, you know, he's come through so many times. One songwriter said, that puts my mind at ease. When I got a new problem, my brother-in-law Ronnie that went to be with the Lord not too long ago, you know, he said, when he sang a song, it's me again, Lord, I got a prayer that needs an answer. It's me again, Lord, I got a problem I can't solve. Well, what's the good thing about that? Because over and over again, God's faithful, amen. That you got a new problem, God still got a new answer, amen. God's got the answer you need for your need. A lot of people suffering, got a lot of folks. I didn't mention the prayer request in the church, but we're going to pray before we go off. We're going to pray for all those at the church that are sick. Got several sick, several in need of prayer tonight, need it right now. God can give it to them. Think about my sister Geraldine for the last 3 weeks. She's been in the hospital on the weekend. She had surgery and lives at Raleigh. She had surgery on her back. I think her 10th surgery on her back. She had that done. And the next week, she, you know, I believe I got it in order, but the next week she fell. And so they put her in the hospital again, making sure she didn't damage anything with what the surgery. Stayed in there the second weekend. Then last weekend she got sick again on Friday. They put her back in there because she had got dehydrated and had some other issues, and they had to fix that, and she's out again. But all 3 weeks she got in the hospital, all 3 weeks she got out. Amen. So you see what I'm saying? If you got a need like that tonight, God's a healer. If you got a financial need, God supplies all our need according to his riches and glory, the Bible said. Whatever you need tonight, if you need a miracle, I know the miracle man. If he could calm the storm for his disciples, that wasn't no doubt. That was just a fact. If he could do that, he's got a miracle for you tonight. Amen. I want to pray. Father, I love you tonight. God, I just thank you that you are faithful over and over and over again. God's faithful. I see it all the time in my life, and I thank you for it so much, Lord, and I pray your blessings on the church tomorrow. God, as we go to church at Souls Harbor, Gastonia, Mooresboro, and Dallas, Lord, anoint you men of God to preach the word, singers to sing, and anoint the altar service to me, used to pray that most of all that you'll move in the altar service, Lord. Heal anybody that's watching right now, any needs right now. Touch hearts and let them be with this program in prayers and support. We thank you for all of it. In Jesus' name, we love you and we thank you. If you hadn't called on, you can call him right quick. Time's about gone. Call him right quick and get your prayer request in. And we hope to see you in church tomorrow, in the morning. Gastonia, Mooresboro, Dallas. God bless you. Good night, everybody. Yeah.
Thank you for joining us on the telecast. Pastor Chambers, wife Betty, and entire congregation welcome you to any of our exciting services. Sunday school, 9:45 a.m., morning worship, 11 a.m., Sunday evening, 6 p.m., and Wednesday at 7. Tune in next time.